Good morning, everyone. Hope you're all doing okay. As you can see, we still have quite a lot of smoke in the air here in Oregon. Shawn has kindly offered to come over this morning on his really nice commando. Morning, Shawn.
Good morning.
How are you doing? All right?
Well, thank you.
Good. Great to see you.
Whew, it's a little chilly this morning.
It is cooler, isn't it? Yeah.
But it feels good. We've had a lot of warm days, right?
Yes, we have. Is the traffic light as well? I suspect it is reasonably light.
You know, over in this little area on this side of the highway, there was a few more people, but relatively kind of quiet with COVID and the forest fires, right?
It's nuts, isn't it?
It's super quiet.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Hey, Shawn, thank you very much for coming over.
You're welcome.
Pleasure to see you and your bike again.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you. Thank you for having me over.
Such a cool bike. Would you mind sharing a few words about your bike?
Oh, sure. It's a 73 850 Commando. I've had it for about 13 years. I think I bought it in 2007. And really, I bet for the first 5 years, I really didn't do anything to it. It was in really good shape when I had bought it. I bought it from a gentleman down in Bend. Sight unseen, in fact. I think I had lusted for a Commando for a long time, for years and years and years, probably decades, in fact. And I remember this popped up in the paper and it kind of fit at least in my mind's eye, what I had imagined I wanted. So, and it was all stock. I think the only changes or modifications that were made, it maybe had a single McKinney and it had flat bars. So it kind of had a little bit of a cafe look with just the flat bars. It's amazing that a Commando can kind of turn into a very different bike just by changing the handlebars. So it attracted me enough. I had bought that. My brother actually lived in Bend, so he went out and checked it out for me. He gave it a ride and he doesn't know anything about British bikes, kind of like me at the time too. And just the fact that the gear shift was flipped, right?
Yes.
It was on the other side. So immediately that kind of threw him off just in a short 1 mile test drive. So that was kind of fun to have a laugh about. Anyways, he picked that up, brought it up, and really it just sort of sat for about 3 years in my garage. I rode it every now and then. I can only imagine how difficult that was because I wasn't familiar with sumping, or I think it was running a Boyer too. So I needed like at least 12 volts. So every time I tried to start it, especially with the compression, I'm like, this thing is darn hard to start. So a lot of it was just ignorance on my part and not really becoming familiar with the bike. So anyways, fast forward to now. I've done a whole lot to the bike and I've gone through it and I've learned it. And I've kind of picked up a lot from the Access Norton site and just from people like you, just sharing their knowledge. So I feel like I've become pretty knowledgeable with the bike. And
you've done a ton of work to it, though, right? Did it look somewhat like this?
It had kind of a cosmetic restoration when I had bought it. The frame was powder coated, and I think it had paint work. So it had new paint on the tank and the side panels. And it looks like, I think they did like a gold leaf lettering. So it's kind of nice. And a Boyer and a single McKinney. But that was about it. Came with the dual Amels. I still had those in a box. And I gave those a try at some point, I think when I switched my ignition to a power arc.
Yeah.
Which is what it's currently running. Just a little bit cleaner when I redid the electrics. I think I've touched everything on the bike. Everything except the engine. That's the only thing I haven't had apart.
Goodness.
I think I just redid the gearbox maybe a year ago. At the same time I did the electric start. A couple other things along the way. I think once you take something out, it's like, well, while you're in there, you may as well do that.
Yes.
And that kind of went to the full wiring harness.
Wow.
The electrical harness I redid.
You've done so much work, though, Shawn. I mean, you've been literally through everything, right? So things that immediately impress you, obviously, you've got a Colorado Norton Works electric start. I love that tail section. You've chopped or cut your fenders.
Yeah.
That gives it a really sleek look.
I sat on that for months and months. Like, should I, shouldn't I, looking at pictures? I sat in Photoshop for I don't know how many nights drawing different versions of that and somehow.
And the drop handlebars are fabulous. The reverse decal on the side panels, that's very, very cool. I love the hump seat as well.
Yeah.
That's very nice.
So
and
that idea, I had seen a bike. There was a gentleman in Hawaii had posted his Norton Commando, very similar bike, but he had this seat. He had the rear sets and he had the clubman style bars. And it was a black commando. It looked very similar to this. So I think once I kind of saw that photo, and that might have been, Mike, right around the time I bought this, I just kind of locked into that photo and said, that's what I want. So slowly, I just sort of, you know, where can I get those parts, right? But the seat was actually pretty easy to find up at Old Brits.
That's a very nice seat.
So it feels really good. And I still have the original seat, right? I put that on every now and then, and surprising how quickly it changes the bike, even the feel, just where you sit on the bike and sort of reside as you ride is just kind of a different feeling. So
it's got a nice, sleek, sort of almost lowrider look to it, hasn't it? Do you sense that yourself? Obviously, the bars make a difference. And
that makes a big difference, but I have noticed that versus like maybe not quite a high rider, but like the interstates and stuff, there's just a different sort of feel. But this one kind of is a little bit sleeker, not quite production racer with clip-ons, right? But it's somewhere between that roadster and production racer. It kind of has that feeling, and I just kind of move toward that end, which I kind of really like. I would love for it to be a production racer or just have another bike, but that's the beauty, and that's been the fun of ownership of this bike, is you can just slowly kind of tweak it however you want. So,
and how did you approach all the jobs then?
I always like to be working on it. I probably like working on it as much, if not more, than actually riding it.
Yeah.
I love to just sort of meddle in the garage on these things. And it seems like every time I take something apart, whether it be for maintenance or maybe something that is broken or failed, I always ask the question, can I make it better, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And with these bikes, there's just a whole world of parts available to us that are upgrades or just better parts. So each of those systems, every year I've approached it, just something has been sort of upgraded. Like one year I just did all the front forks and I put the Lansdowne in there, which just made sense because I'm like, well, I'm in there, they're a part. Why not just upgrade it?
So
great modification. I've been really, really happy with those. And I got these from Don Pender.
Yeah.
I think
he's
now sending or selling the Lansdowne. And then, of course, that leads to the rear shocks. You know, it's like, okay, which shocks are they? Do I just go with the regular Hagon? Or what was on there were fine. They just sort of weren't in keeping with what I had done to the front. So I went with the Icons. I've been really happy with those. I rarely touch those two things other than just changing the fluid in the front. I've never adjusted the rear. It just always kind of fits. I never go too up. I don't do any long rides with weight, so they just kind of work.
The starter, though, that was a big project.
Starter
as well.
Was just this last year, and it was not planned. I always knew that was coming. I've had a few knee surgeries
from
all the running. So it's just getting harder and harder, and I'm like, oh, I don't know how long I want to keep doing this.
It transforms your bike, though, doesn't it?
But yeah,
makes it so usable, doesn't it?
You hit a button.
Yeah.
I don't even have a kickstart on it anymore.
Oh, yes, right.
I left it off. Just kind of fun. I love that. But it does start really well. It started really well before. It's just, now it's just that much easier.
And the turn signal's very tasteful. The whole thing is really tastefully done.
You
made a lovely job of it, Shawn.
Thank you. Yeah, the turn signals, they seem to work.
Yeah.
Yeah, and all the electrics. That's probably the one thing I inherited with this bike, where the electrics were just a mess. When you take the tank off, it was all original, but it was just a hobbled mess of things being removed, right? It had the boyer with a new reg rack, and just the way that was sort of installed and everything was just sort of taped up and gummed up over time. And it was hard to get the tank on, actually, with that big boyer under there, because I think it had like a breakout box or something like that. All of it was just squeezed in there. So I finally replaced the entire harness with a custom harness.
Oh, right.
And just redid all the electrics with LEDs. I already had the switch gear and tied those in, but it's just all so clean underneath.
It is.
My favorite part is taking everything apart and just looking at the inside because it's so clean.
The switch gear is great.
Switch gear is great. That was from Colorado Norton Works as well. Very early. That was one of the first things I had done. I remember when I first got this bike, the switch gear that came with these, it was really hard to figure out. And I'm like, nothing's labeled. Everything was a little bit backwards. Not to mention the switch gear for your feet. Everything was just kind of flipped. You know, I grew up on dirt bikes. So in my head, everything worked like a traditional motorcycle.
The wheels, beautiful. They've got like stainless spokes, those polished spokes.
Yeah, and those are original on the bike for me.
Nice.
So I inherited those too. They've always been really great.
Two AML carburetors. Are they the premieres or anything?
These are the premieres.
Okay.
So it had the single Mikuni, which worked really great with the boyer electronic ignition. But then when I went to the power arc, the Mikuni didn't start as well. Those two, they were compatible, but not perfect, right? So I pulled out the old AMLs that I had in the box and rebuilt those, put those on. They worked pretty good. I mean, they ran really great. They started really great. And I could feel I liked the way they rode. They had more power. They even sounded loud. Everything just felt better.
Yeah.
So I kind of fell in love with the AMLs, but I could never get those slides to just behave perfectly. It was always, whether the bike was hot or cold, or they would stick a little bit. But I also have the sync from, I think it's Don Pender as well.
Okay. Oh, right? Yes, that gantry, yes.
The gantry, yes. Right. So essentially that's kind of fixed your AMLs at the top, and then they're bolted to the head. So there's very little tolerance right there. So if you have a slightly sticky slide, those things were binding up as soon as I did that upgrade.
Just in terms of how much fun it is to ride, it looks like you really enjoy riding it, and it's a cool bike.
I do love riding it, It's a good feeling. It fits me really well, just ergonomically, right? It kind of fits you like a glove. So that's what I really enjoy. Feels like my bike, right? Like, and I think I've already mentioned this, but that's what I love about the Commandos is they're so flexible in how you set them up.
You've made it your bike.
And it feels like everybody does, right?
Yeah.
It seems like everybody touches them just a little bit, but they always kind of look the same. They all look like Commandos to some degree. But I love the flexibility in the platform, and I love how we can upgrade them just oh so slightly to make them and tune them just the way you'd like them. So it's always been my pleasure in ownership, for sure, just to be able to tweak it. So it's a runner. It goes pretty well. So I've been happy.
Very nice.
Gotta love that.
That's a good sound.
Thanks very much for watching, guys. This has been another tale from the cul-de-sac. Please remember to subscribe and click the little bell, and you'll get a notice whenever I release a new video, usually every Sunday morning and sometimes during the week.